Hello and welcome. In this session, we are going to look at how to update Drupal core. Occasionally, you will see some messages on the screen saying that your Drupal is out of date and it needs updating. Updating Drupal core is important to have your site performing better. So if you go to reports and available updates, you can see that the current version we are using is 8.13. And it says recommended version is 8.16. If you see an updates are available, click on the download link and save it on your computer. Now I've downloaded the current version of Drupal on my download folder. Now let us look at our file system, Bitnami Drupal 8. By the way, it's very important before we do the update, make sure that you have backed up your site first. If you're following this tutorial series, you should know how to do backup. If you haven't done your backup yet, please do that now. Files and database now before going any further. If you don't do that, there is a risk that you might lose your site. Before backup, put your site on a maintenance mode so that when people visit your site, they know that there is some maintenance happening. So go to configuration and maintenance mode. Put your site on maintenance. Save configuration. So configuration option has been saved, so your site is in maintenance mode. When you put your site on maintenance mode and when users visit, this is what you see. This is what the users will see. The site is under maintenance. Okay, now go to your file system, that is Bitnami Drupal HD docs. That's our local setup here. All right, so what you have to do is, so we are going to delete some files here. Right, what are we going to delete? We are going to delete except modules, profiles, sites, and themes. Delete everything else. So what I do is I invert selection so the others are selected. So the other files are selected and delete them. But the thing is, if you all really want to be very cautious, what you have to do is just create a new folder. Let us name it the old to remove something like that. Then select this module, profile, sites and themes. I'm holding the control switch to select like that. Then invert selection, so other than these are selected. Then move all these files to here. Hold to remove. So that is moved. The reason for doing that is just in case if you need some old files, you can always get it back. We can delete this later after our update. Next thing to do is move the freshly downloaded file to here and extract it. Select the file and extract. Okay, extract it. So it will take about a few minutes. Now that is done. Go into the newly extracted folder, this one. Select module, profile, sites and theme, only these folders, and delete them. So that is deleted. So after deleting module, profile, sites and themes from that folder, select the rest of the files and cut and move to one step. Paste it in here. So that is pasted in here. So you get something like that. So this folder should be empty now. That's right. Delete that. So that is gone. If you have been running your site for some time in the production, you might have changed something in the HD access file or robot.txt or something. And this is the time you just go back there and copy that and overwrite on this one. After updating these files, next thing to do is go back to your site and navigate to a page called update.php. You should get a page like this. So we are in this update mode now, and it will update the code and all that. Say continue. So Drupal database update. There are two pending updates. Let's see what they are. Drupal decided these are the two pending updates needed. Apply pending updates. So it is doing the updates now. It's updating the database as well. It says database is updated. So I don't see any failures. That is very good. The next thing to do is go to administration page, under configuration, under performance, clear all caches. If your site is at any time there is some error, something you don't know about, the first thing to do is come here under configuration, development, and clear all caches. Often it clear a lot of issues. So make sure you do this first before you investigate any further. That's a general tip. So we cleared all the caches. That is good. Save configuration. Go back to your site to see how everything looks. Everything looks fine. We are still in the maintenance mode. So let us go online and take this maintenance mode off. So we are now going online. Save configuration. Let us look at the reports, see how it is looking. Go to reports, available updates. Now it is core 8.16. So Drupal core is now up to date. That's good. Go back to the site to see everything is okay. The maintenance mode message is gone. Our site looks good. Once you know that the site is all up and running, go to your file structure and remove these ones. Alt to remove and Drupal compressed. That's removed. There's a lot of files in there, so it will take some time to remove. I'll let it do that. In the report, you notice that there is a what is called module update. That's a separate issue. We'll be looking at how to update modules in another session. In this session, we have updated Drupal core and it is up to date. Very good. Updating Drupal core is an important administrative activity. Let me go through that the steps again because it is very important. For core updates and security updates, the process is the same. First, you back up your site, both file system and database. Then put your site on the maintenance mode. Then manually download the updated Drupal version from the drupal.org site and upload the update to the root file folder and uncompress it. On the existing root folder, delete everything except is very important, except modules, profiles, sites, and themes on the existing site. Don't delete those, okay? Then, from the newly uncompressed file, delete modules, files, site, and themes. It is from the newly uncompressed file, okay? Then, you moved whatever the rest of it to one level up to the root folder. Then, go to sites, update.php, and the system updates by itself. And if you have any what's called access error, you fix that. Then you clear the cache, then go to the front page to see everything is okay. And if all okay, remove the site from the maintenance mode. Okay. So your site is now online and you are up to date. Now you mastered the art of Drupal core updates and security updates. Both processes are the same. Okay. Keeping your Drupal core up to date is very important for better performance of your site. Okay. Thank you.